and welcome back to the 8-Bit Guy. In this episode, we're going to have a look at the Speakin' Spell. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're going to say, but David, didn't you already do an episode on the Speakin' Spell? Well, actually, I did several years ago. So why am I doing another one? Well, it turns out that at the end of 2019, they actually released a new Speakin' Spell. And I went ahead and ordered one on Amazon, and well, here we go. So apparently this has been on the market for just a little bit over a year. And I thought, why don't we have a look at it and see how it compares with the originals. So let's have a look at the packaging here. The box is actually nothing like the original. The original was completely enclosed like this. But still, I mean, that's not a big deal, and I'm certainly not going to hold it against them. Now, I noticed that it says classic 80s design. And that's sort of true, but sort of not. And that's because the original design came out in the 1970s. However, to be fair, the 1970s design has raised buttons like this. And this is the kind you would have seen in the classic movie E.T. as part of his intergalactic phone. However, they redesigned the Speakin' Spell in the 1980s to make it look like this one. And clearly, this is what they were going for with the remake. So in that regard, I guess I'll give them a pass on the classic 80s remake. It also says here to try me by pressing go. However, it doesn't seem to do anything. Neither does on. I'm guessing the batteries have died. So let's take this thing out of the package. It's attached to the back of the box with these plastic things. One thing of note is that they both have the Speakin' Spell logo, but the modern version is missing this tiny text here that says copyright TI 1978. And in fact, it's missing the Texas Instruments logo completely. Also, the round speaker is a little bit more pronounced and visible on the original unit. On the side, you can see the new one is missing the headphone and power jacks completely. They're nowhere to be found on the unit at all. And let's have a look at the back. The removable tab is obviously unique to the modern unit and probably designed so that it has a demo mode. And the battery compartment is also different, which isn't surprising considering it appears this thing runs on three AA batteries. I'm not sure what kind of batteries these are, but I'm going to make a wild guess they're probably junk. Okay, so let's put some good batteries in there. Oddly enough, I still don't get any activity from this thing, so I guess I'll go ahead and remove this little tag. And well, now it seems to work.
Spell level A. Press go to begin.
Okay, the first thing I notice is the screen. It's a backlit LCD screen, but it has a really narrow viewing angle. You have to look at it just right to see the text, and I think the text is larger. I'm also not convinced this is the same voice either. Well, what we need to do is put some batteries in the original version so we can make a comparison. The original takes four of the C-cell batteries, and once I get them in, I can immediately tell a big difference in the weight of these. It's probably mostly the batteries. So let's power them both up.
Spell level A. Press go to begin.
So the original unit doesn't speak at all when you first turn it on. Now let's compare how they sound.
Spell health. Spell does. H-E-A-L-T-H. That is right. Now try guess.
Wrong. Try again. Does. D-O-E-S. That is correct. Now spell four as in four wolves.
Okay, so they definitely sound different. The modern one has a bit higher fidelity, but does try to mimic the older sound to some degree. Looking at the screen, the original definitely has smaller text, but it's way easier to read being a vacuum fluorescent display. You can read the new one in the dark, but again, you need to be at just the right angle. As you can see, just a slight tilt and all the segments appear lit. The original unit can be read at any angle. Another difference I noticed is the labeling of the number sign, or pound key. The new unit says volume, where the old unit says module select. Now, that key is designed to select your expansion module that went behind the battery compartment in the original. It's safe to say the modern versions don't have this, so I guess they decided to make it a volume control. You just keep pressing it and it cycles between three or four different volume levels. Well, it's time to take this thing apart. Holy cow! I mean, I was expecting it to have a small board, but not that small. Just a refresher as to what the original looks like inside, it has a full circuit board with separate processors, RAM, ROM, etc. This modern sucker has the screen on one side of the board and everything else on this epoxy blob on the back of the board. That's cost reduction for you. I'm actually really disappointed, as I was hoping it would at least be somewhat hackable, but there's just not much here. Okay, so what are my final thoughts on the modern Speak and Spell? Well, I've been trying to think of something objective and something good to say about this product, but believe it or not, I'm having a bit of a problem thinking of anything. I think it boils down to two problems. The first problem is that if you go back to 1978 or even the early 80s when I was a kid, you know, I actually did not own one of these, but several of my friends did, and I thought they were really cool, and so did they. In fact, most kids thought these were pretty cool. Now, when I say kids, we're talking kids 10 years old, you know, 9, 10, 11 years old. We thought these were cool, and the reason we thought these were cool was because they could talk. And they were kind of like a one-trick pony. That was really the only thing exciting about them. I mean, the actual games that you play on this, to be honest, are not that exciting, right? So the only thing cool about it was the fact that they could talk. And today, let's be honest, any kid that owns an iPad or an iPhone or whatever is not going to be excited about a product that talks because they're already used to it. It's normal. Back in 1978, it was extremely rare to find any item that could talk. It seemed extremely futuristic, almost magical that it could talk. But today, that's just not a selling feature. So I think that's the problem. I'm like, I don't think that there's any kid out there today that's going to see this in the store. They're going to be like, Mommy, 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 I want the Speak and Spell. Because, I mean, they probably already have a tablet or a phone or an iPod, you know, something like that. And they're just not going to get excited about the talking aspect. And the games on here, like I said, in and of themselves are not compelling enough. Spelling things is just, it's just not that exciting. Okay, so that's problem number one. So problem number two is that means the people these are being marketed towards are not your modern day kids. They're being marketed towards people of my age who are seeing the nostalgia in this and wanting to buy it for their kids so that their kids can be bored with it. But anyway, point is, so if they're marketing this product to me as a nostalgia and not as a good product in and of itself, then I think that it's not that great because the screen is terrible. And it also doesn't completely mimic the behavior of the original. Admittedly, it looks really good. I mean, it looks, in fact, I keep getting them mixed up here between the the original and the new one. So admittedly, it looks really good. But the screen is just, it's a real disappointment. And I understand this is vastly cost reduced from the original model. I mean, I think I paid $29 for this. And the original model, especially accounting for inflation, would be probably a couple hundred bucks. So I understand it's vastly cost reduced. There's no way they're going to get a vacuum fluorescent screen in there. But they could have at least put like a segmented LED screen. And I think that would have given the same look and appearance as the old one. Or if they had to use an LCD screen, they could have at least opted to spend, you know, an extra 30 cents more and gotten a screen with a better contrast ratio, a better viewing angle on it. And that would have made a big difference as well. So, I mean, So again, I think they cost reduced the screen just way too much. So, I'm not terribly thrilled with this. And I mean, I kind of think it's cool. It's a cool idea to bring back a vintage product like this. But let's face it, there's a reason. There's a reason why the Speak and Spell was discontinued. And that's because it was no longer relevant in the marketplace. And I think that this product is quite literally being sold as nostalgia. And nothing, I don't think it offers anything else beyond that. So, you know, if you want something to put on your shelf, you can get one. But the reality is, you can get the original ones. They're not that expensive. There were so many of these made. You can get them on eBay for little to nothing. So, again, it kind of makes you wonder, if you just wanted it for nostalgia and you wanted to put it on your shelf, why not just get an original? So, anyway, hope that's not too much of a downer. That's all I can think to say about it. So anyway, I guess that wraps up this episode, and I'll quit rambling. So as always, thanks for watching.